Hi, it's Roberto Della Vecchia, and welcome to another flat picking and bluegrass guitar lesson. Today I want to show you three cool licks, one in G, one in C, and one in D. Before we get started, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell to be notified for new videos every single week. And if you're a beginner at flat picking guitar, be sure to pick up my free Flat Picking Guitar 101 video crash course. The link is below this video. And you can also join my instructional channel, Flat Picking Experience at True Fire. Again, you find the link below this video and sign up for a 7-day free trial. Okay, let's get started. The first lick is a G lick, and it sounds like this. A little bit faster. Alright, so it's a bluesy lick, and we are using the G minor pentatonic scale here at the 3rd fret. I'm sure you're familiar with this fingering. This is my root. And this is my root again. Octave higher. Okay, so I'm playing four notes like this, and I want to bend that B flat very, very slightly like this. See? You see that? And then I play again, you see I'm going very quick slide with my pinky on the 3rd string and then hammer on. Open G. Let's put it all together. Okay, if you prefer, you can also use your ring finger. Okay, so just use the fingering you prefer. Just make sure that you play your down ups correctly, by the way. So it's a down, up, down, up, up. So we have two upstrokes in a row. Up, down, up, down, up, down, hammer on, down. Now the lick is 1.5 bar long, means that it starts on the first beat and it ends with an open G, and that's the 3rd beat of the 2nd measure. Okay? 3-4. So I really like to have those two beats available, because I can use those two beats to play some notes to target the next chord. So let's say that I have a couple of bars of G followed by a C chord. Okay? And I can play something like this. Okay, you see that? Maybe I have a D chord, so I have G for two bars, and then I have a D chord, so I can target the D triad. So, something like that. So you see, it's really useful to have those two beats available at the end of the 2nd measure, and that's why I really like licks that are 1.5 bar long. Okay, Now let's move on to the next lick. This is a C lick, and it goes like this. Again. Okay, I really like this lick because it's taking us from down the neck up to the seventh position. So it's connecting here the first position to the seventh position, and the seventh position is really useful for us flat pickers because from there we can easily go to a G chord here, right? We can easily go to a D chord here, or maybe here. And so the seventh position is very, very common when we are improvising. And that's why I like this lick. It's quite simple. Let me do it slowly. So you see, I'm starting with the C note here on the fifth string, third fret, index. Ring finger, slide, and then I move to the fourth string and I play index, middle finger, ring finger. Now I move to the third string, play index, then I play ring finger, and now I slide up two frets and I finish up with this G note. I just repeat the last two notes. So here at the very end I have a syncope. So I have it up, you see, up, up, down. So down, up, slide, up, down, slide, up, up, down. Okay, and well, I see that I'm moving, I'm going from that low C, and then, and here, when I'm in this, here at the fifth position, I'm thinking about the G, the C chord that's here at the fifth fret. It's a G fingering, right? That's a C chord. And then I slide up and I move to the next C chord that is here. You see the triad? Here. Okay, so that's what I'm seeing when I play, when I'm playing that lick. All right, and now let's play the last lick. The last lick is a D lick. In particular, this is a D dominant lick. It means that works when the D chord goes back to G. So we can use the lick when we have a D for two bars, and after that we will have a G. Something like that. And the lick sounds like this. And then there is a G chord, okay? Now, first of all, let me show you the position. The first position is here, that's a D note, 10th fret, see? You can see my triad here. And then I move that position two frets down. And then I go middle finger and ring finger at the 7th fret, then 6th fret, and then 5th fret. All right, so just practice this real quick. play a four note pattern that goes like this. So it's an index, then middle finger, then index again and open E. So two notes on the third string, two notes on the first string. Down, up, down, up. Okay, now I want to repeat that same sequence here. Okay, so you see how it works? Very easy, right? And then I go to this position at the 7th fret and I play, but this time I don't play the open E note, I just play three notes. And then I move down one fret and I pinch with my middle finger, and I move down one more fret and I pinch again. And after that we need something to finish up, to something that works over a G chord. Okay, and again this lick is one bar and a half, so this is the fourth beat, one and two and three and four and one, two, three, four. Okay. All right. If you enjoyed this flat picking and bluegrass guitar lesson, let me know in the comments below and give this video a like. It really helps to support me. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next week, same flat time, same flat channel. Ciao.